Hello, this is Jawad Hamidi, co-founder of TATBIM. In this video, I'm gonna teach you how to model wavy surfaces on Revit. Please subscribe us for more videos, also turn on the notification button to be the first person who will notice our new videos. There are many ways to model wavy surfaces like Dynamo, Rhino Inside, but the goal of this video is to work with Revit environment only. It can be a good exercise for your math skill ability too. Let's open Revit. This is the final surface you can achieve at the end of this video. This surface is fully parametric. You can change the frequency of the waves and also the height of them. Let's change it a little bit to see the reaction of surface. This surface has two parts. The first one is two-point adaptive family and the second one is base surface. The first step is to create adaptive family. You have to know the basics of the math in Revit to be comfortable with this video. Otherwise, it would be so hard for you to work along with me. But you can watch it anyway. Let's make another surface here. First of all, I draw a rectangle, then click on create from bottom. It will make a box for you, but it's not a big deal. Simply delete this. Okay, it is the surface that we are going to work with that in this video. We need to transfer this to the surface pattern. Click here, turn off one of the direction. It's up to you. There is no difference. What direction do you want? Or which direction do you want. For placing our adaptive families, we need nodes. You can turn it on from here. For this one, we need a two-point adaptive family. Okay, let's create the family from the application menu. Click on a new family. Let's open the generic model adaptive family template. As we mentioned earlier, we need a two-point adaptive family to place it here and here, and it will be repeated along the path. For this starting point, we need to place two reference points here. The place of the points does not matter because we are going to work with parameters and we don't care about the distances. Okay, we should select them first, and after that we use spline through points command to connect the points together. If we want more flexibility in our object, it is better to use reference lines. You can convert this model line to a reference line from here. Also, we need to convert these points to adaptive points. Simply select them and convert them to adaptive families and adaptive points from here. For the next step, we need some point at the top of this line to be able to make a sinus frequency. But before that, let me create a dimension for this length. Let's change our unit to meter type UN and change the parameter to the meter. We need to create a parameter for this length. We will need this for our formulas. But you must create an instance parameter because I want to be able to change factors for each family separately. If it would be type parameter, we can achieve something like this. And it would be the same geometry for whole of the surface. But when we make parameters as an instance parameter, we can make this kind of frequency surfaces. So make sure you are creating your parameters as an instance parameter. Let me return to the family. The number of points is not a big deal here. But the more points you have, the softer surface you will achieve. But you should know your effort will increase in creating of parameters. But the way we will do it is same for all of the wavy surfaces. So don't worry. For this purpose, 5 or 6 points would be great. Let's place the points, put this on drawn face, and place the points on our reference lines. The distance between them are not important because we want to work with their parameters. If we would create some parameters for distances between these points, it wouldn't be an effective way, because when the length changes, the other point won't react to the change. So we are going to work with just parameters, not distances. To prevent this, we use from normalized curve parameter. This parameter is a special parameter. The sub value of the parameter is 0 and the end value is 1. For some curve types, this evaluates the curve along its extent very easy. For example, the midpoint of a line is at parameter 0.5. it doesn't matter how much distance you have. You just care about the percentage and the parameter. So it's the best way to do these kind of things. Let me add another point to this line. Then we can divide the line 0.15 by 0.15. The first one is 0.15. The second one is 0.30. The third point is 0.45. The fourth one is 0.60. The fifth one is 0.75. And the last but not least is 0.9. These points don't have any offset parameter, and we put them just for controlling other points. We have to do a work here. I know it's boring, but trust me, the consistency of family depends on this work. The first step is to set the work plane to this point. Set your drawing mode on drawn work plane and place the points. We will repeat this process for all of the points. Let's bring all of these points up to test the consistency of point to the reference plane and give them an appropriate parameter. At the moment, the height of point does not really matter, just bring them up to test the family. We can move one of our adaptive points to test the family. It is a good habit to test your family after each phase. It will save such amount of time in your work. You can see that all of the points are connected. This is the thing that we want. It's great. Now I want to make a profile across these points. You have to select them in order, then click on explanatory points. That's the curve we want. Let me test it again. It's working. Maybe you are asking yourself, what an ugly profile. But we are going to make it beautiful with some formulas. Wait and wait. Let's put the dimension of the lens again. Now we need some formulas to control the offset of these points. You have to select each point and create a parameter for their height. Name convention is really important in these kind of families, that we have lots of parameters. It helps you to organize your family. So be careful about the name convention of parameters. At this moment, we have one parameter per point that controls the height of the points. Let's bring it up a little bit. Open the family tab window. I want to create an additional parameter which will control the height of our frequency. Click on the new parameter. Let's call it factor. Put it on instance mode. Common is okay. Put it in dimension group and type of the parameter must be number. Okay. Now we have factor lens, but we need another parameter to control the angle of our sinus formula. Let's create another parameter for that. We call it angle. Be careful about the type of parameter. It must be an angle, not length. We have all of the parameters we need. The offset of other point will be controlled with these three. Let's give value to angle. 45 would be good as starting point. I put it on 45 because I want the 45 degree interval for my wave. You can select whatever you want. So, shall we start the beautiful part? Are you ready? I want my factor to be 0.1. It is better to keep it under 1 for an appropriate manner of family. So type length multiple factor multiple sinus in the parentheses angle in the formula column. But for the next ones, we need to sum it with an interval angle. This interval angle defines the number of frequency in a specified length. When it is a big angle like 90 by 90, you will have more frequency in your profile in comparison with 45 by 45. Now there are many ways to test our formula, but it can be good idea to draw two lines and dimension the angle between them and make it connected to the angle parameter. Now, when you move one of the lines, the angle between them will change. But when you look at the family, you will understand it is changing the frequency angle. Let's delete this, we don't need it. It was just for testing the formulas. Let's save the family and go back to the project. For placing adaptive families, you need to go to the Create tab and Component. Click here and on this node to place this family. For repeating this family all over the surface, you need to select this and click on Repeat Bottom in Modify tab. To be able to change the parameters value of each one, we need to select them and remove the repeat group. In this stage, for changing the values, you have two ways. One using dynamo, the second one is manual. For the sake of this video, as we mentioned at the first of this video, we want to work with Revit environments only, so we are going to work with manually. Let's select all of them. Use filter to filter the components and let me change the factor to have a higher height. For creating a wave in another direction, we need to use interval angles again. Let's use 90 degrees interval here. Okay, it is done. Select the component and click on Create Form. There it is. Our wavy surface is ready. Nice work. Although you still can change the parameters, select the components and change the factor to have different surfaces at one project with one family. It is really great to work with parametric modeling. You can also assign patterns to these surfaces. Let's change the number of patterns here. This is the end of the video. Good luck. Let me know in the comment section. Did you like our tutorial? And also don't forget to subscribe us for more videos. Also turn on the notification button to be the first person who will notice our new videos. And also you can share your works on my social media as we will mention here and ask your question in the comment section. Good luck. See you on the next session.